हूँ।
हाय नितिन,
यस
हाय नितिन।
हेलो एवरीवन, सॉरी
हाय
फॉर
हाय, गुड
जॉइनिंग।
इवनिंग।
यस
यू नाउ वी कैन स्टार्ट ऑन द टॉपिक।
ओके ओके, बिकॉज़ टाइम इज प्रीसियस, सो वी हैव टू। आई ऑलरेडी गिवन द टॉप टॉपिक इन द सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज एक्सपेक्टेशन किल्स हैप्पीनेस। सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज दैट, सो प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड टॉक अबाउट द टॉपिक। एंड या आई स्टार्टेड द रिकॉर्डिंग ऑल्सो, लेटर यू विल फाइंड दैट वीडियो इन यू ऑन यूट्यूब, सो यू कैन रिव्यू योरसेल्फ एंड यू विल रियलाइज वेयर यू डन द मिस्टेक, बिकॉज मिस्टेक इज अ पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट। एंड ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट।
हेलो,
यस
निजाम, यस
यस
योर एक्स माय हेडफोन मेक्स प्रॉब्लम, दैट्स व्हाई आई डू नॉट लिसन एनीथिंग। मे आई एक्स टुडे टॉपिक्स?
यस यस, टुडे टॉपिक इज एक्सपेक्टेशन किल्स हैप्पीनेस। इन चैट सेक्शन यू कैन फाउंड दैट।
ओह ओके,
in chat section you find the topic, you read that topic, and meanwhile we are discussing the topic, then you get some point and today you engage with the topic, and now you are very much audible to us. So who will start the topic? I think let's begin with the Nijam, because every day he not got much time, so let's give the opportunity to Nijam to talk on the topic. So first topic is expectation kills happiness. So topic is clear, Nijam? Your audio have some problem, I think.
Yes, I have some problem. I fix the problem, then I will start my speech.
Okay. Okay, no problem. Okay, so let's start with the Sanjeev. This topic. Unmute yourself, Sanjeev, and start the topic. And Nijam, unmute yourself, so this recording will be good. And later we will review ourselves on. Okay. So, Sanjeev, please unmute yourself and talk.
Good evening, everybody.
Very good evening.
Today topic is first topic is expectation kills happiness, and the second topic is peace is possible without justice. Third is the world does not need religion. Actually, the sentence I want to say that the world does not need any religion. Let us start with the first topic. Expectation kills happiness.
One we will discuss.
Yes. So first, I want to explain that what is expectation. Yes. Expectation is something that we actually not we get up till in our life. So, those we have the already get is not our expectation. It's maybe in the something in the past we have a thinking and now we are getting. That's the completion of the expectation. But if you talk about the expectation, is looking towards the future, where we want to be. It may be fictional. It may be fictional and it may be realistic, but the many other people they thought to be something at good place where they actually aim to be in your in this life. For this, they work whole day and night, and for the life they go for that expectation. Expectation may be the big, or expectation may be the general, but many people have the such type of expectation that I am not saying not achievable, but they have the something more acceptation, then they have caliber. Because if I give an example, an elephant can never be run like a tiger. If elephant thinking such type of expectation, then it's a fully a fictional expectation. That's kill all his journey of that elephant, because for that expectation, elephant is not actually made to fulfill. So everybody should have the limitation of us in his life. So everybody should try to make such a type of expectation that he or she is able to capable to fulfill that dream. And if we make such an expectational achievable dream, then it kills our happiness. It's the truth. But many other people are in the society who are the also awarded, they dream like such a dream that is looking like an unexpectational, unachievable dream, but they make it possible. But the example of this type of people are very less. So in our life, we have to dream such a type of the works which can we actually achieve. And now I am talking about what is happiness. Actually, happiness is not attached with the only at the final achievement we actually get. Happiness is actually associated with the all that movement in with which we are attached. Like happiness we can see in our world. Happiness is the happiness we can see in the others' work also. Happiness we get from the all our minute to minutes. But if we are only thinking that our happiness is associated with only our final target which we only dream, that is only able to give me a such type of happiness which I am actually want. So I think people should try to achieve a small target so that make him much happier in his life. So overall, I want to say that people should make such expectation that the he or she can capable to get in his life, and he or she also try to associate his happiness with each and every moment in his life, so he or she can enjoy the every moment and full associated with the happiness, joyful, and lots of creativity in his life. So I can conclude that expectation kills our happiness. If our expectation is such type which are not achievable, our happiness only depend on the our successful success. Otherwise, our happiness is only assuredness. So such type happiness is not okay for us. Our happiness only. Associated with each and every moment, we should enjoy the every moment of our life, and we should also enjoy the every moment which we have actually expected or not expected in our life. Okay.
Thank you so much, and you given some very good point that you explained the what is real happiness. Happiness is not always associate with the one point, like if someone want to become something, so if achieve that point, then only not person become happy. Happiness lies in every moment of that journey, whatever you want. So that is very good, the point you highlighted. And Yeah, you come with a very good point, and I appreciate your ideas. And so let's give the chance to the other participant. So Nitin, unmute yourself and talk about the topic. First one is expectation kill happiness.
Okay. Hello, good evening everyone.
Good evening.
Now just I'm coming from hospital, so I'm joining late session. But now first topic is our expectation of happiness. Is it right?
Let me share my screen so it will be visible to in your entire screen. Yeah, expectation kills happiness is topic in chat section. Let me again type this thing so we get it. Okay.
Expectation.
Expectation.
In our life. Oh, sorry.
No problem.
Expectation. Sorry.
Topic is that sometimes we thinking something extra. Sometimes we expect something which can't we do like that. Our some.
Yeah,
in
our daily life we have many expectation, like we are doing something but it is not happen, then we unhappy. The reason will be unhappy because our expectation is not comes true. Okay, right now everyone's life is a important part of this, so everyone expectation is something he wants, some he doing some, and he is planning for something. But in case your achievement you will not get, then you will be unhappy. But I think if you want, if you accept it, so you doing for achieving that the position and doing your best for the thing to achieve. I will explain. I am explaining with a small story of my life. In lockdown, I am just planning for doing a business. Just opening my cafe where I serve many types of juices and shakes. We accepted this, the area, whole area we covers and sell many juices or sandwiches like and pastas, but the owner will not ready to give the shop. Then my all expectation is not true, then I will be depressed or unhappy. But I still hope, I hope, and I am doing something. So then after I just planning and other things according to area. Then after I started a business of clothes, so it will be pursuing good. So I say that in conclusion that everyone's life has expectation, many expectations, but we are achieving with a positive attitude and working hard with continuously. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you come with the good point that sometimes we expect something but we don't get in our life.
Hello.
Yes, you are.
I have question with the Nitendra, you said that you wanted to start a cafe, but due to some reason you unable to start that. So I just want to know at that moment, when you know that now my cafe is not started, how you feel. Is this distracted you or kills your actual happiness? Is there any happiness associated with that time? How you actually feel at that moment?
Okay, so that time I have a 6 to 8 month planning for opening cafe, but the owner where I'm open the shop, the owner was not given the shop. So I'm just thinking and feeling depressed. So it a long term planning will totally destroy.
Yes,
but now.
But yeah. You feel depressed at that time, and it kills your happiness on that time.
Yes, everyone. If you want something, but you don't get it, get that, then you will be happy.
So, previously I am just discussed that actually our happiness is associated with our expectation. If that breaks, that kills our morale. Actually, and it make me I just want to know how many days you just feel depressed. How many days
not a long time, within a month and some days some days. Then after
it's
I
meant,
will
it's meant it means that you have a strong the bold person. And you just recovered from the depression too fast. That's a good point for you, because many people are distracted, fail their idea, but they cannot able to recover from that.
Depressions are
actually the more reason behind the many problems of the mental disorders.
Actually,
I want to say that. If someone expectation kills, it's nothing more about it. He have the losses, he have the given much time, then he can cry, able to even weep. But it not means that it spends more and more times in the depression. He should try to recover as soon as possible. And if someone he or she also associated with the some as such type of people that always himself for herself encouragement to work. It's helped her also to recover from that depression. Yes,
it's a good point, and very clearly you said that. I small story of why. Then today's journey, everyone have a girlfriend or boyfriend. So everyone expected to him or her, then he will say every morning good morning, every night good night, but he didn't it. Then after we fighting each other, and the relation will be totally destroy. So I think we should always happy.
I think everybody you talk to whom about it's happiness only associated with good morning and good evening, but actual things is that his happiness is not associated with this type of activity.
Yeah, of course, I'm agree with you.
If someone is do for you, that's okay, but it not that means that it is always do for you.
Too much expectation kill the person also, because that time person was totally got distracted and doing something else, sometime not focused, sometimes people are driving something, so they are thinking something that I expect from that person, but I don't got same time. So sometimes if the expectation kill so many things in even the relationship, so many things kill. So we have to not expect much. Yeah, you have to work, but don't expect much from others. Even yourself also much expect. You have to do your part, because if you expect something, then it's directly related to the happiness. So many people are expecting, and they are thinking, if I done, then I will done the party. If I done something, but we have to balance. Buddha said that, not become too much happy, not too much low. You have to in between that. So always this will work.
Yeah, of course.
Let's give some other people chance.
Okay.
Yeah.
So hi Manish, thanks for joining this call. So we are discussing the topic. Let me again type in the comment section. So you will got the topic, and we covered almost first topic. So let's give you time to speak on that topic. So our topic is the first one is expectation kill happiness. So please unmute yourself if you have some idea about that topic. Please unmute yourself and speak about the topic.
Yeah, just let me find out my microphone.
Okay. No problem.
Yeah, I gone through this topic. So.
Okay, that's great. Okay, so let's give the another person chance, then I will come back to you. So meanwhile, then you prepare your topic.
Nizam.
Nizam?
Yes, yes, I am. I am
listening. You are now audible. You are very much
yes,
audible.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am audible.
Yes.
Today topic is acceptation kills happiness.
Yes.
In my personal life, I passed from university in 2001. That time I joined a private company and I earn salary 4,000 taka per month. That time I do not fulfill my demand. Always try to earn more money. That means my expectation was high. Nowadays, I earn more than 1 lakh per month, but I cannot fulfill my demand. That means when income increasing, expectation also increasing. That's why expectation kills happiness. I think human brain designed for always unhappy. That means we cannot fulfill our expectation in my life. That's all.
Hello. Nizam?
Yes.
I think you are not right that the human minds are not designed for this. Just demand and more expectation. Human minds are actually designed for creativity. Human minds always enjoy new things. Like, human minds always enjoy with the nature, with someone new people. Actually, human minds, you tell that it needs always expectation. Not expectation of money. Actually, human minds demands always a new thing, new creativity, new enjoyment, new environment. Actually, it bored after some time. If actually thing associated that, we all the things are say associated with the money. I think our demand is actually something new thing. We think that if we have more and more money, then we can fulfill our demand. But this is absolutely correct. We have to develop a such type of quality in our body that create such type of habit that is not. And not we can buy with the money. I think this is the best way to substitute our mind. Like we start loving with this someone new people, with talking, enjoy with the nature, enjoy with the animals. But these are the costless. Enjoy with the yoga, enjoy with the exercise. This is also keeps satisfaction for our mind, that is free of cost. But if our happiness are always associated with the such type of things that demand too much of money and that we cannot easily gain, that's create too much problem. Yes, am I right?
Yes.
This thing is right.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, first time I listen the word from the Nizam clearly. But today you come up with very good, and I'm hoping that you will continue this call till the last, and you will speak on the every topic whatever we mention in this group. So let's give the chance to Manish on the first topic, expectation feel happiness. Please unmute yourself and speak on
it. Yes, so am I audible to her?
Yes, you are very much audible.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so basically I agree with this topic, means expectation kills what can I say, joy or you know, happiness. And why? Because you know, always people expect more and more.
Okay.
As I think Nizam said, so when you are in job, then your current salary is like around 5 lakh or per lakh, 5 or 6 lakh per annum, and then people are not satisfied. Just because they are not satisfied with their current situation, they want something more. So always expectations hurt, or like it reduces joy or happiness. So yeah, I agree with this thing. And also, as Sanjeev suggests, there are lots of other way to deal with this thing. Like you can do some yoga, meditation, and you can enjoy the things like loving animals and like that. So yes, these are the best way, according to me, to deal with this problem, I can say. So yeah, I agree with this thing.
That's good. So let's come on the second topic, and I think everybody talk on that topic. So I also want to give my point on that topic. So expectation kill happiness. Yeah, expectation always kill the happiness, because even in the family, you are expecting from your parents or something, and if they are not have some money for you, then you are thinking that you are not feeling happy, because you are expecting from, even you expecting from close one is all more hurting to you. So I think expecting from nobody is a good choice. Just you do your just use for something, but not too much. That thing I want to add, and I believe in the Buddha philosophy. Too much is everything is either it's happiness or either it's sadness. Everything balanced form is good for our health and everything. Even in success, if you want to become successful, for success you have to be maintained. That one be also the balance. Sometimes you got highest marks, sometimes you got a less mark. It's also not a good habit. So you have to in balance form. So it's a very real fact that expectations always kill the happiness. So if you want to become more joyful person, then you learn the technique how to deal, how to avoid the expectation from others, and just to enjoy the life without expectation. Yeah, expectation is good, but everything has some balancing. So let's move on to the second topic. This is only I spoke about the first topic, and let's move on to the second topic. So I'm choosing the random person, and peace is possible without justice, and I want to Nitin to talk first on this topic.
Hello. I want to 5 minutes only.
Okay.
Another person has called.
Okay. So, Sanjeev, start with the topic. Second, peace is possible without justice.
My answer with this question is no. Because.
Put your point.
Yes. Here is question that peace is possible without justice. Everybody knows that if someone not get justice from the either from the nature, either from the family, either from the society, then it's his morale will be down, and if morale will be down, there is unsatisfaction in his mind and in his whole work also, it shows in any form. Because if a person is not satisfied, not get justice, then his mind always is in the state of wandering to get a fair justice. Actually, he is thinking that why this type of injustice is happened with him. The big question in the front of him. So, how it is possible he get a peace inside him? So my answer is that the peace is not possible without justice. A lot of the in this world we see that many are the migrant people, always search for land. So they go for the one country to another country. I think in the Bangladesh also the many Rohingyas have become, but the country itself does not want any migrant come in his own territory. If you talk as a human being, that person is how much suffering that in he or she is looking in his surrounding. Some people get everything, get his land, get his home, get his food, get some good job. But I am such type of person who even not got a land, not got any job. I am always in this searching that actually it is injustice for him as a human being. Because if you are born as a woman, then I have given a land by the freedom, we have also get air from the nature that is free of cost. We get water also that is free of cost by the nature. Actually, nature has given everything to everyone. But in this society, some people is getting everything, and some people will not get even something. That is a gap inside between the people's society. If I'm talking about this, someone is very rich and someone is very poor, how much gap in between them? That's create a very large gap inside the human being, in the mind itself. It is actually in the form of injustice. So it never create a peace to the society. For creation of peace in the society, it is necessary that we should develop a such type of nation or the society in which every person got a fair justice in the form of freedom, in the form of equality, in the form of equal status in the society. If I am talking about the men and women, is there any inequality, or is there any injustice in between them, or is there any hierarchy of man or the woman as a sub hierarchy? This all form of injustice we looking throughout the society is just a type of a thing that create unsatisfaction on peaceful environment to the society. So my point with the peace is that for the creation of peace in the society, there is a need of equal justice. People just feel I am not any got any injustice. Society is accepting me as everyone. So we keep a type of satisfaction with self. But then there is another picture of this whole thing is that if everybody has got everything from the society, but inside him a feeling is seated there that I am not injustice, then it will also a type of trauma that inside the person, not created by the society. So such type of injustice which he as he only just have in the feeling, that should be recognized by him. Suppose everybody have the equal opportunity of get job in his country. So the competition, if there is a competition in which he not got selected and someone is got selected, then he should feel that it is we both are got equal opportunity, but our competitor is working better than he got the job. I am not doing better. In this way, he can be satisfied with himself. But if he think that it is a wrong thing with me, given by the done by the God, that I am not got selected as someone is getting. It is only a type of faith. Faith that God is given opportunity to him, but it not given to him. I am just wanting to say that every man and woman have satisfied with himself also. If God and society and whole world have given a equal opportunity, equal status, he or she should also feel that. Then a type of peace is inside there. So I am talking about two type of the injustice. First is injustice given by the society. First injustice that is person only feel, but actually not is clear in the society. A lot of the problem with the casteism, you can see that. But people have feel that one caste is greater and one caste is very low. And in their inside feeling, it is kept there. And they always become unpeaceful, always try to humiliate some other caste, due casteism, a lot of unethical activity are be doing by him because of injustice feeling by him. But it is not injustice actually. So I conclude my point that peace is possible if with justice, not without injustice. Justice with justice, he feel from the society and feel from himself also. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your valuable information. Whatever you said, very clear, and you come up with so many points in a few minutes. So I think you are talk about so many things, and that is very appreciable. And you expect that without justice we can't find the peace, and you given so many example like casteism, and in the front inside our mind we think that inside feeling is that sometimes unethical activities also happening in society. Some person is a lower caste, some upper caste. Sometimes those things are not seen by naked eye, but it's happening. So I think only justice can make the peace in our heart, because by the court we given the justice is okay. Because if not, if someone got some problematic problem, then if not got a if nobody listening their problem, then that person always in trouble. They never got peace. Like if someone got a accident or something, someone killed somebody, so then person without justice never gone the peace. So justice word, who did, why this happening? And I got good point from your discussion. So that was very appreciable. So let's give the chance to other, and let's give the time to Nizam. I think he's listening to us, and unmute yourself and come on the topic. Second. Nizam? Am I audible?
Yes, I am audible. What is second topic? I don't know.
Okay. Second topic is
peace is possible
without justice.
Sorry?
Peace is possible without justice.
Okay, let's simplify
the topic.
In our society, without justice, we got the peace.
Like someone killed somebody, and we are saying that please forget us. Without peace, can we become satisfied with that? Peace is possible without justice. It's our topic.
Actually, peace is not possible without justice, because there are lots of crime in our society. If law and order situation force do not take action against the crime, then peace will be destroyed. That's why without justice, peace is not possible.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're right.
You want to add something new?
Okay. Okay, let's move second topic to Manish. Manish, unmute yourself and talk on the topic. Yes. So, thank you, Ranjan. Actually, here I am against Sanjeev Nijam and you. So, I think it is not good thing. So what I understand, or what I feel about justice and peace. So basically, according to me, justice is something like one is wrong and other is right. So based on these things, every time justice made, right? So when people are thinking like that, wrong or right, so peace cannot be exist. Okay. So my answer is very straightforward. Yes, peace is possible without justice. Then how? Then it is very simple. Do some yoga, meditation, and all things. So if you are satisfied from inner, then definitely you will get some peace and all things. So no need of justice.
Okay.
Because
I want to do the counter argument with your thing. You said that it's possible by the yoga meditation. Suppose that if some girl is raped by someone, and then you suggest that you do the yoga and everything.
No.
So it's possible that without justice, that person got satisfied. Whole family suffered from trauma.
Just start from the starting, like a woman or girl, whatever it is. So when you are doing meditation and yoga, then you will not go into that mentality.
Right?
You can control your emotions, your sexual desires. Yeah.
But talking about that principle of life, but if somebody doing something wrong, at that case, what thing we do? Justice is required.
That is the thing I am saying. Just to reduce or remove those things, we should learn yoga and meditation. So that we cannot make mistake in this bullshit.
Terrorists came in Mumbai and attacked that so many.
Ranjana,
okay.
Ranjana, I want to add point. Manish is actually right that peace is actually get from some tools. That tool is actually the yoga, Buddhism, they give peace. Learn or teach this type of thing to get actual peace from the society. Because society is full of expectation, full of work, and this world is full of sorrow. So if we get out of this sorrow by the medication, by the yoga, I think two types of the societies are there. If we talk about the humanitarian approach, humanitarian approach is saying that in this world, what is ever, what is there and what will be there, it only for the single person, which I am. So if something is wrong happen for me, if I ignore them, then that nothing will affect on me. This is philosophy actually work behind the peace. Peace is a peace through the yoga. Yoga actually a type of connection that connect with us from myself, from inside.
Yes, exactly.
This yoga and peace are actually create inside peace. Peace from where we get peace? From outside, from someone, others? No. We get peace from only from our inside. So these tools, as Manish has said, peace which we can get through the yoga and yoga. It's possible. But for the whole society, it is not possible with this type of tools. For whole society, there should be a mechanism for the businessman, from the unlawful man, which is doing, like Vandana said, the rapes. These are for these controlling, for the working for the society, for their rule for society, there should be a rule, a system that gives us justice. Okay?
I think both is required, yoga as well as justice. Because everybody is not going to meditate, everybody is not going to follow the right path. If somebody is doing wrong thing, so then justice is also required. So yeah, Manish said
that start
from the yoga and meditation.
Yeah, so nowadays even, you know, most of the organizations are going to teach the meditation and yoga in the Naxal areas, you know. So that is a very good initiative our NGOs are doing nowadays. So yeah.
Yes, Nizam, you want to
see? Yes, I want a question. How can bring national peace by yoga? Yoga or meditation?
Yeah, you asked a very good question.
Vandana, I want to explain this question.
Okay.
We just started from this 21st June to make International Yoga Day. We know all that. Because Nizam had asked the question that how we get a national peace through the yoga. Actually, I want to say that peace is from where we want to actually establish the peace. We want actually get a peace inside the mind of people. And that is only possible through the some ethical method that can actually works. I think you know, you hear about the this yoga and the other lots of activity that's running inside the jail also to change the human's nature. Human mentality. This will work if every person is trying to change. Every person is trying to change herself, and got peace from inside, from her side. But it is not possible throughout the society. For the society making peace, there should be mechanism. I think Nizam was satisfied.
Yes,
For the society, we should have some mechanism to get everybody justice. Now, to get to the next topic, as the time is going to
be. Okay. Very nice discussion going on, and it's really appreciable. And clear the both the point, yoga as well as justice. So, I think it's the best conversation ever we did. And let's come with the third topic. And the third topic is the world does not need religion. So what is your opinion? Just a question. The world doesn't need religion. Nizam?
World does not need Religion.
Religion. Yes, yes. The world doesn't need religion. Are required. Religion is required because every country has different religion. Religious people. Some are Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, and Christian. So the world required, really required that religion, or what you think about that religion? World does it require the religion system, or it's not necessary for the woman? Just some principle is required in our life. What you think about that topic?
Actually, religion means religion needs for human. It does not need for world.
World required that religion or not? Because if the world have this one religion or one common thing for principle of the life, is okay? Or everybody have the different religions, different way of thinking, different culture, it's okay? Or what you think about that thing, that topic? The world doesn't need religion or required religion? Are you getting topic? Let's put on the chat section again. Got the topic.
Okay, you want to add, Sanjeev? You want to add something?
Okay, you want to add, Sanjeev? You want to add something on that topic?
Yes, Nizam, do you have any point?
It is very difficult question. To me.
No, it's not question, just discussion now. If you want to discuss that topic.
Actually, I have an explanation very clearly. Yes, Nizam, you can, if you have any question, then ask me. Actually, the question is that, is this in this world, there is a need of any religion or not? So the first point is come with the religion. What is religion? Religion is a type of path which a human being follows throughout his whole life. This path may be the making by this some society or making by the himself. But more than more general cases that this path is made by the society. That is religion. So which we can go our journey, but it not necessary that we can follow absolutely the same path. But it is a well scripted, written path, so which every person if follow, then his life will be better. Because this path has been made by not a single person. This path is made by the from 2000 years ago, means up till whole of the generation. Means whole of the up till a life form that can survive through that path. If I'm talking about the Hinduism theory, the Hindu lives with their live their life with some set of rules that is not made by the single people, that is not survived by that, so that not a single person survived by that. Many peoples are the survived by that path and get a good life in his whole life, whole journey. So the religion is the same thing. Religion makes us path for the person, so which his journey of whole life will be good. I have example, if someone is born, then which type of the functions are should be there? If someone will be get married, then which type of the functions should be there? If someone got a death, then which type of ceremony should be there? There should be some well-defined path. If this is not, then someone is dead. Nobody will ask what will do with this dead body. If someone have to marry, then no one doesn't is interested in his marriage. There is no function, no ceremonies are there. So the religion makes some set of rules that everybody is follow that rules and get a good life in that. So I'm talking, the topic is that, is this world called need any religion? My question is yes, this world has need a religion. by a single group. If someone is born in another ethical group, then there should be another religion for him. If I am born in India, then I have this set of religions, because my environment, my place, my people, language, all are different. So I have to follow my religion, my path. Actually, I am not able to follow some other paths of life. So actually, we have to respect another religion, some other religion also, but we have should some religion, some set of dharmas should be there with us. That should be help for us. I have example. I have an example through a question. Should we need a family? Yes, everybody should say, everybody says that, yes, I have need of family. If I ask question to him, why you need a family? Then he said that if my family will be there, then they will always be helpful for us and always help for us in if I am got ill, if I got in trouble, then they will be more give me moral support. If I am getting old, then they will also make me all the things to support me. In the same way, there is a religion. The religion give me a better path in the society. If religion works better, but if religion doesn't work better, then it will be unfit for the society, become a worse for society. So the religion should be fair, religion should be good, religion's path should be better for the human being. If there is something not good in some religion, then it should be changing, flexible in nature. It should be according to the generation. Yes, the world need a set of rules, set of orders, that in the form of the religion itself in the society, and it also guides the people for why they are born, what should they have to do. They should not lie. They should also help for the human being. These all only learn through the religion. That make a chapter without any teacher.
I'm totally agree with that religion is required. If we have some religion, then we will have not much trouble. We will easily got after that what we need to do, and set of some parameter in life, it's always be good. And that thing always that missed by the so many people. So why I invest my time in this thing? Already there is some certain rule already made. So if you follow that thing, you will your life becomes simple. So you given very good example of family, just like we make the family because we want to happiness or something. So similarly, the religion's purpose is to make the life simple. So I got this point from your discussion. Yeah, really good point. I think right now Nizam totally understand the topic. So please unmute yourself and talk on the topic. Nizam, I'm audible. Please unmute yourself, Nizam. And if you have some point, please add on it.
Yes, I have no point.
Okay. My one question is that, what do you think about the religion? And what religion you are following?
I am a Muslim. That's why I follow Islam. I think religion is most important for human life.
That's it. You said that it's important. Whatever your religion follow, you have to some parameter you have to follow according. That religion actually make our life simple. And there is, I think every religion is a very beautiful and
it's my belief that every religion have some good purpose to making that religion. And I think difference always is good, because if you have different religion, I have different religion, then I can come with your religious festival. I can enjoy your festival. And if I have different religion, then you can enjoy my festival. So together we can enjoy more, I think. It's my belief.
Okay.
I want to add something else in this topic. I think it's time to wind up the call. And anybody has anything?
Nija,
are you added in our group? WhatsApp group?
Sorry?
We have made one WhatsApp group. You are in the part of that WhatsApp group?
Someone delete me from your WhatsApp group. I asked him where is my fault, but she did not give me any answer.
Don't worry, send me your number, I will add you.
How can I give you message here? I don't know.
In chat section, there is a chat section.
Chat box.
Yeah, there is chat box. When you click inside there is three dot button. There is option in a call message.
Yes, I got.
You message me, then later I will add you, because you are very active participant and I don't want to miss you in every conversation.
Thank you so much.
Please share your number. Otherwise,
yes. I okay. Yes, already I give you.
Okay. Thanks a lot. I will add you, and you will join every day.
Yes. That's I will join. I will join every day.
Okay, one more thing. If you have any interested learner of English, please send them also.
Okay.
Thanks. And this recording you will got in YouTube channel. I will share with you later. Okay.
Thanks all for joining this call.
Okay.
We will meet again same timing.
Okay, thanks all for joining this call.